Hi guys, welcome to the super easiest video on net present value calculation. You will be shocked. Remember, you can always go back to my website for more free videos. Alright, if I go too fast in this video, no problem. Just watch my slower video by following the instructions down here. Alright, so I'd like to start with the word net. What do we mean by net? Well, it's usually the result of different amounts combined. Let's say you are at an expensive restaurant and the food is $100, but you have a $15 discount. Then we can say that the cost is, or the price is, $85 net. Okay, so now how do we apply that to business? Well, let's say that you gave your friend $100 today under the agreement that you will get back $105 next year. Okay, so I write this down as negative because you're paying it, and this is positive because you are receiving it. So in this case, you have a net value, a simple net value of $5. Where do we get the $5? Well, 105 less 100 is $5. Does this look like a good deal to you? I think it seems like a great deal, because you give 100, you get back 105, you gain 5. However, this is only the net value. It is not yet the net present value. Present means today. And when we think about the net present value, because present means today, we have to think about the time value of money and interest rates in the market right now. So let's just pretend that interest rates right now, given by the bank or any other risk-free place like the government, let's pretend that interest rates are at 6%. Okay, so what does time value of money mean? It means that $1 today is worth more than $1 given to you tomorrow. And isn't that true? Wouldn't you prefer that I give you $1 today instead of promising to give you $1 tomorrow? Even if my promise was good, you'd prefer to have the $1 given to you today. Why? Well, because, for example, $100 or $1, whatever, let's just say $100 put in the bank today at a 6% interest will be worth $106 next year. That's the same as saying, if bank interest is at 6%, then $106 given next year is the same as only $100 given today. You see? So then, now that we know that, how do we get the net present value? Well, it's very simple. The first step is this. Boom! What is this? What are these scary numbers over here? Well, if you don't already know, this is the simple present value formula. Okay, the simple present value formula. And what makes it different from the net present value formula over here? Net. This one is simple. Well, this is for one number, okay, instead of a combination of numbers. When we say net present value, we're talking about a combination, remember? So that's the difference between simple and net, okay? So where do these numbers come from? Well, very simple. This $105 comes from here. This 0.06 represents the interest rate over here. And the negative one over here represents this 1 year over here. As simple as that. Now, first important question, why is it 0.06? Okay, why not 0.6? Well, remember, in percentages, 6% is written as 0.06. Okay, if you wrote 0.6 here, that would be 60% and not 6%. Okay, why is it a negative one over here for this 1 year later? Well, remember, we're trying to get the present value or the net present value of these two amounts today. So or in this present value formula over here, we're trying to get the value of $105 given next year, but we want to know the value of this $105 today, 1 year earlier. So to represent the fact that we're bringing this $105 backward by 1 year, we put a negative one. It is negative because we go backwards. Okay? And, oh, very important. In your textbook or with your professor, you might not see the present value formula looking like this. It might look something like this instead. But that's the long way. This is the traditional way, because if your calculator sucks and you don't have a scientific calculator, then you cannot do the negative one. And you have to put a positive one. But if you put a positive one, then you have to bring this stuff under the 1.105 and make it look like this. I do not recommend this, okay? It's more confusing if you ask me. So I suggest you just buy a good calculator. All right, so back to our formula. Are we done yet in the formula? No. Remember, net present value. Net is a combination of these two. So we also have to do, boom, this. Okay, so what is this? So first of all, I'll explain later. If you want, you can delete this. I might as well explain it now. If you want, you can delete this, and the value will still be negative 100. So don't be surprised if your textbook just has the 100 over here, but there's nothing over here, because you can delete this if you want. But personally, I do not like to delete it. Why? I like to keep it consistent with this over here to avoid confusion. Okay, after you're already used to all these formulas, then go ahead and delete it. Okay, so let's continue. Now, where does this negative 100 come from? Again, comes from this. Where does this 0.06 come from? Comes from the 6%. Where does this negative 0 come from? Okay, where does this negative 0 come from? Remember, in this case over here, we had a negative 1 because we wanted to know the $105, the value of the $105, 1 year backward, right? 1 year earlier. However, in this case, this negative 100, you are paying today. So you're bringing it back by 0 years. So that's why I have a negative 0 over there. But like I said, you can delete that if you want. You can delete this whole thing if you wish, and the value will still be the same at negative 100. But I prefer to keep it so that it's consistent and not confusing. All right, so now, using our scientific calculator, okay, we get this. Boom. Right, 105 multiplied by 1.06 raised to the negative 1, we get 99.06. What does this mean? This simply means that 99.06 is the present value of 105. If we take interest rates into account, then $105 given next year is the same as $99 given this year. Okay? Next step, let's simplify this. Boom. Okay, there we go. You see that? So this is what I mean by you can delete the 1.06 if you want, because as you can see, when we simplify this whole thing, Kim comes out the same as this. All right, so there we have it. We now have our net present value formula. So if we simplify it further using our scientific calculator, we get what? We get, boom, negative 94 cents. See, as you can see, this negative 94 cents is a lot less. So our net present value is negative 94 cents, which is a lot less than the simple net value of $5. Okay, so what does this mean? Okay, what this means is that in simple numbers, we gain $5, but in present value dollars, meaning we take the value of this money today, then we lose 94 cents if compared to what you would have gotten if you deposited your money in the bank instead. Okay, to simplify it further, in a case like this, if net present value is positive, you win. If it's negative, you lose. So there, I hope you enjoyed it. So remember to share it if you like it. I have more free videos on my website, MBAbullshit.com, more than on YouTube. So please do visit my site. You can also see my videos on YouTube, follow me on Facebook and on Twitter. So that's it. Have a great day and goodbye.